Hello, dear students. In the previous class, we were discussed about the Werner's theory of coordination compounds. So, based on the Werner's theory of coordination compounds, so let us discuss about the structure and bonding. Structure and bonding of cobalt 3 amine complexes. Cobalt 3 amine complexes. So first let us discuss the structure and bonding in case of COCl3 6NH3. Okay, so now we have to discuss about the structure of this complex COCl3 6NH3. So the coordination number of the cobalt in this complex is 6, because this ammonia ligands, so ammonia is ligand, so ammonia ligand, 6 ammonia ligands will surround the cobalt. So therefore the coordination number of the cobalt in this complex is 6 ammonia ligand, therefore the coordination number is 6. Okay, so the coordination number, so according to the Werner's theory of coordination compound, so it corresponds to the secondary valencies. Okay, so this coordination number are the secondary valencies are occupied by the ammonia molecule. So therefore 6 ammonia molecules are present, so therefore the coordination number of cobalt in this complex is 6. So then the chloride ions, so the chloride ions are bonded to the cobalt by the 3 primary valencies, because the oxidation state of cobalt is +3. Okay, +3 means 3 positive charges. Okay, so the 3 Cl minus ions mean 3 negative charges, 3 positive charges and 3 negative charges. So therefore the primary valency is satisfied by the chloride ion, 3 chloride ions. Okay, so hence this compound, when it is dissolved, when this compound is dissolved in water, it gives total 4 ions, so in which 3 Cl minus ions and 1 coordination sphere, this one. Okay, so when this complex compound is dissolved in water, it ionizes into total 4 ions, 3 Cl minus ions and 1 coordination ion. So hence we can write the structure of this complex as CONH3 6 times Cl3. Okay, so this is the coordination sphere, so this is secondary valency. As you know, according to Werner's theory, it is non-ionizable, this doesn't get ionized, only the primary valency get ionizes. Okay, so when this complex get ionizes, it gives one complex ion and 3 Cl minus ion. So therefore 3 plus 1, total 4 ions will be produced. Okay, so next move on to the one more complex of the cobalt, so that is COCl3 5NH3. So let us discuss the structure of COCl3 5NH3. So the structure of this complex, so before going to this, so let us write the structure of this complex. So the CO will be present in the center. So the 6 ammonia ligands So these are the ammonia ligands. So six ammonia ligands are present and three chloride atoms, Cl, Cl. Okay, so this thick line represents the secondary valencies, that is ligand and metal atom linkage, and this dotted line indicates the primary valencies. Okay, so let us discuss about the COCl3-5NH3 complex. Okay, so in this complex, so the coordination number of the cobalt remains 6. Okay, but now the 5 positions are occupied by 5 ammonia molecules, and the 6th position will be occupied by one of the chloride ion. Okay, so this chloride ion exhibits both the primary and the secondary valency. Hence, in this compound, what happens? When it is dissolved in water, it gives a total number of three ions, in which two are chloride ions and one is the complex ion. Okay. So in this complex, the coordination number is 6, remains 6, but the five positions will be occupied by ammonia molecules, and one position will be occupied by the chloride ion. So this chloride ion will satisfy both the primary valency and the secondary valency, because the coordination number of the cobalt is 6. Okay, but only 5 ammonia molecules are present. So therefore, one more secondary valency is satisfied by the negative ion. So in Werner's theory, according to Werner's theory of coordination compounds, so one of the postulate says that, so the secondary valency is satisfied by either negative ions or neutral molecule. So in this complex, we have only 5 neutral molecules, ammonia. So the secondary valency is 6. So therefore, one of the secondary valency will be satisfied by the chloride ions. Okay. So therefore, one of the chloride atom, out of 3 chloride atoms, one chloride atom will be in the secondary valency. So therefore, it doesn't get ionized. So when this complex is dissolved in water, okay, so this complex, when it is dissolved in water, it gives a total of 3 ions. It gives 3 ions. So that is 2 Cl minus ions. So out of 3, one is involved in the secondary valency, and one the complex ion. So that is COCl NH3 5 times 2 plus. Okay, so now the structure of this complex can be written as, see here, COCl NH3 5 times Cl2. So this is ionizable, this is non-ionizable, this is primary valency, this is secondary valency. Okay, so now the structure of this complex can be written like this. So the cobalt is a central metal atom or ion. So here what happens? One chloride molecule will satisfy both the primary valency and secondary valency. So this thick line indicates the secondary valency, and this dotted line indicates primary valency. So this one of the chloride atoms satisfies both primary valency as well as the secondary valency. So NH3, so Cl, so this is primary valency, dotted line, NH3 and NH3. Okay, so let us move on to the one more complex compound. Let us consider one more example. So let us discuss about the structure of CO Cl3 4NH3. Okay, so in this complex also the coordination number of the cobalt will remain 6 because the secondary valencies are fixed. Okay, only the primary valencies are variable. So the coordination number is secondary valency, and the secondary valency or the coordination number of cobalt is 6. So therefore it is fixed, it doesn't change. Okay, so now the 6 valencies should be satisfied. So the secondary valency should be satisfied, but we have only 4 ammonia molecules here. The 4 ammonia molecules will satisfy the secondary valency, and 2 Cl minus ions, 2 chloride ions will satisfy the both secondary valency as well as primary valency. Okay, so here what happened, the 4 positions, okay, out of 6 the secondary valencies, the 4 positions will be occupied by the 4 ammonia molecules, and the 2 positions will be occupied by the chloride ions. Okay, so these 2 chloride ions, okay, so they will exhibit both the primary valency and secondary valency. So when this complex is dissolved in water, it produces, okay, it produces 2 ions. So that is one chloride ion and one complex ion. So that is CO Cl2 NH3 4 times plus. Okay, so therefore according to this explanation, so the structure of the complex can be written as CO NH3 4 times Cl2 Cl. Okay, and the structure of this complex can be written as, so the cobalt, the central metal atom, so here the 2 Cl minus ions will satisfy both the primary valency and secondary valency. So here ammonia molecules, 4 ammonia molecules, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and 3 chloride ion. So this satisfy only primary valency. So these 2 chloride ions will satisfy both primary valency and secondary valency. Okay, so next one more example. So that is CO Cl3 3NH3. Okay, so here also the coordination number of cobalt is 6, it is fixed. But here what happens, the 3 ammonia molecules, okay, the 3 ammonia molecules will occupy the 3 positions, okay, and the remaining 3 positions will be occupied by the 3 Cl minus ions. Okay, so therefore when this complex is dissolved in water, okay, it doesn't dissociate, it cannot dissociate, because these 3 ammonia molecules will satisfy the secondary valency, and also remaining 3 secondary valencies will be satisfied by these 3 Cl minus ions. So therefore there is no dissociation. So the complex can be written as CO NH3 thrice Cl3. Okay, so the structure can be written as CO NH3 three molecules of NH3 and three chloride ions will satisfy both the primary valency and secondary valency. Okay. So next let us discuss about the demerits or limitations of the Werner's theory. The limitations of Werner's theory. So the Werner's theory fails to explain the nature of bonding. Nature of bonding within the coordination sphere. Okay, so this is coordination sphere. Okay, so this is coordination sphere. So Werner's theory doesn't explain how these, that is, the molecules or atoms are attached to the central metal atom. So that is, Werner's theory fails to explain the bonding within the coordination sphere. So this theory also fails to explain the complexes having other than the coordination number 4 and 6. Okay. So this theory explains only the complexes having either the coordination number 4 or 6. Okay. So therefore, this theory fails to explain the structure and complexes having other than the coordination number 4 and 6. So that means the Werner's theory of coordination compound is can able to explain only the structure and bonding in cases of the complexes having the coordination number 4 and 6. Okay. So also this theory fails to explain the or fails to distinguish between the square planar and tetrahedral geometry. Square planar and tetrahedral geometry, because in both the cases what happens, the coordination number will be 4. Okay, for square planar geometry as well as for the tetrahedral geometry, the coordination number will be 4, but the Werner's theory fails to distinguish between the square planar and the tetrahedral when the coordination number is 4. So next demerit or the limitation is that this theory, that is Werner's theory, fails to explain why the ligands satisfy both the primary valency and secondary valency. Okay, so why the ligands will satisfy both the primary valency and the secondary valency? So he doesn't give the explanation for the ligands which satisfy both the primary valency as well as secondary valency.